Warrenpoint, seaside town of Carlingford Lough. This is a beautiful place. People come here for day trips all the time. But we live here, not just for one day,
but every day. What is there for us and everyone else to do in this community?
In our community centre, there's many clubs. There's squash courts, there's badminton courts, there's tennis, there's basketball, there's a gymnasium, there's chill out rooms, there's homework clubs, there's art rooms, there's old age pensioner bingo, and there's old age pensioner dancing, and of course, there's our creche. But look what it is now!
It is also a seaside town.
Its population is similar to Warrenpoint.
Although it is smaller, it has more for the community.
Let's compare.
This is Cookhill Leisure Centre. They have an astroturf pitch outside with a gym, a spa, recreation hall and a swimming pool inside. And this was our swimming pool, but it's now filled in with concrete. We won't be swimming here. And just across the road from the Cookie Leisure Centre, they have their football playing fields, their tennis courts, the bowls playing area and their kiddie player area. They are all very close together and accessible to everybody, and you don't have to be a member. And this is our public playing field. Unfortunately, we can't play football here because most of the time there is broken glass and dog poo all over the field. But what do you expect when there's 19 places to purchase alcohol in our community, but nothing to do? Don't get me wrong, we do have other football facilities and tennis courts in Warrenpoint, but they're out of town and you have to be a member. And let's face it, not everyone wants to play sports.
This is Jim's Youth Centre in Cookhill. It's open 7 days a week. We're here to look at the facilities they have. Let's look around. This is Jim's Cafe. This is used by the youth of Cookhill's community to catch up with friends, to chill out, and to do homework. This is Jim's Computer Club. This is where kids and adults of all ages come and they can do computer courses, and they're also starting photography next week. This is Jim's Games Room. This is where kids can drop in, play games, hang out with friends, and stay off the streets. This is Jim's Function Room. This is where they hold youth discos and fundraising events, to name a few.
I'm here in Kingdom Youth Club in Cookhill with Eric, the treasurer of Kingdom Youth Club. Eric, what can you tell us about the facilities and the runnings of Cookhill Youth Club?
This hall here was built, the GAA, but the youth club took it over. You can see it's laid out there for basketball, and we've 60 to 70 use it every night.
And Eric, what all goes on inside the Kingdom Youth Club?
Well, in the hall here we would have indoor Gaelic, indoor camogie, we have basketball, all different activities in here. Upstairs we have a snooker table, we have a pool room, we have a computer room. Basically, just all sports around here, and upstairs at night, Tuesday nights, is table tennis.
I'm here with Kayleigh Rogan, leader in charge of Warrenpoint Youth Club. Kayleigh, what can you tell us about here about the facilities in Warrenpoint Youth Club?
Well, as you can see behind me, Connor, this is Warrenpoint Youth Club. It's quite small on the inside. We can only hold an average of about 40 to 50 kids a night. The club itself cannot hold that amount of children. It's not big enough. We only open one night a week on a Tuesday night from 7 to 9, and sometimes we have to turn people away. Some nights we had kids in and there was about 70 of them, and it just wasn't feasible to run it in that premises. There are no other premises in the town for us to run, as we searched for a long time to get this premises, and we hope to keep it, but we would like to have something bigger.
We have been showing you about what we think about facilities or lack of in Warrenpoint, but it's not just us.
Let's see what the people of Warrenpoint think.
Well, at the present time, there's very, very little for anybody, really, senior citizens or children.
I have two youngsters at 5 and almost 7 who I have to run between two halls on a Tuesday evening for 7 o'clock, both starting times. I feel if there was a community centre and everything could be all under one roof, where both children could partake in both things as they would wish to do.
Now, I belong to 3 different clubs in Warrenpoint, and we have to go to different areas for, you know, meetings in every club that we belong to. I think we're badly in need of a community hall that would serve the young people, the middle-aged people and the elderly people, all the one building.
Facilities in Warrenpoint are really, really poor. I think there's about maybe 3 or 4 different halls, which are very small, and they will house about maybe 20-30 people at one time. We should have one big community centre in order to facilitate for the young people, the elderly, and for people of my age.
We need more facilities in our town for the community.
Would it not make sense for a town with practically the same population as Kilkeel to have the same investments and facilities?
We want to be proud of our town. Forget you and forget her too. Said if I was richer, I'd still be with her. Now ain't that something? And though there's pain in my chest, I still wish you the best. With all forget you, I know. Had to borrow.